Tourette syndrome is a neurodevelopmental disorder, and what it means is as the brain matures, the disorder also evolves over time. So what children typically present is called tics. And tics are basically sudden, rapid, repetitive abnormal movements which are not under the voluntary control of these children. And the typical age of onset of these tics is somewhere between 5 to 10 years. But most definitely, to be able to be diagnosed with Tourette syndrome, the tics have to start before 18 years of age. It is very common, and it is 3 to 4 times more common in boys as compared to girls. Tics are of two types. One is a motor tic, which is abnormal movement of a muscle or a group of muscles. So these could be simple motor tics, which include episodes of eye blinking or squinting, face crunching, face twitching. The second type of tic is a vocal tic. So this type of tic includes certain vocalizations like sniffing sounds, throat clearing sounds, and to a very rare but more severe extent, there could be obscene words or socially unacceptable words used, but that's something very rare. Tourette syndrome is a lot more than just tics. So it involves a lot of comorbidities that we need to be screening for when we see these children in our clinics. The most common ones are attention deficit hyperactivity disorder. Anxiety and depression could also be common in children with Tourette syndrome. Even sleep difficulties and other symptoms like headaches could be problematic too. There are two ways to treat the tics. One is medical treatment, which is giving medications which are pills and liquids available. So these involve medications that actually affect a certain chemical in the brain called dopamine. And then there are also other group of medications that we also use to treat symptoms of ADHD. There is also a form of behavior therapy that is available for treatment of tics. It is called comprehensive behavior intervention for tics. And what it really involves is that you work with a therapist at least once or twice a week. They help you to recognize your tics, be more aware of your tics. The urge that comes before the tic, they help you to recognize that and help you learn certain compensatory behaviors that may make your tics look more purposeful or help reduce the intensity and frequency of these tics over time. Many kids eventually outgrow their tics. Tics, like I said, typically start between 5 to 10 years of age. They can get worse as the natural course, how it evolves. They can get worse somewhere between 9 to 12 years of age. And between 12 to 18, a lot of children notice improvement in their tics, or they may even completely go away. But a small subset of children may go on to have tics even into their adult life, but that is a small subset of population.